Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're here with
Kathryn Allison. Woo! She has been in Aladdin, Wicked, and Company.
So let's get on with this video.
Here we go.
Broadway time.
How did you get into theater?
So I got into theater when I was in middle school. I had a best friend at the time, and we were in the same ballet class after school. And so her sister was super into musical theater, so I would go over her house, and we'd listen to all these shows, which I had never, you know, really heard before. And yeah, she gave me a mix CD of like all the hits at the time. So Little Shop, Little Women, Les Mis, Aida, and I was just completely obsessed. So that's kind of how I fell in. Actually, it was more like elementary school. It was, you know, like fourth or fifth grade was when that came about. Yeah, and then ever since then, I've been hooked.
What is your favorite show mishap?
I was thinking about this last night. I'm what people would like to call, I'm someone who falls a lot. So
same.
Yeah, I'm just clumsy, and luckily, I'm gonna knock on wood. I haven't done it at company yet.
Good.
But
that's good.
But yeah, in Aladdin, I would fall a lot. Like, we had these beautiful dresses made by Greg Barnes, and we were in heels. And, you know, it was just a little, one of my first weekends on. If you've ever seen the show, there's this moment at the end where we're all in the wedding, and every single cast member lines up in a line at the back of the stage. Mm-hmm. And I was the only person on the ground. Like, we got back there for the line, and I was like on the ground, and everyone was looking at me like, girl, you gotta get up. You gotta go. So yeah. So that would be my thing is I fall a lot.
Yeah, same. No, I have to agree because the other day I was like, oh, I have a scar. Where did that come from? Like, yeah. I went to a random scar. I was like, where did that come from? Oh, I hit my head.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like, how did we get here?
It's to the point where I have to be able, I think I'm fighting sleeping. Like, I'm fighting in my sleep because I wake up with like scratches and bruises. I'm like, what is, I went to sleep. I'm waking up with like a whole bunch of stuff. So.
What is a movie you would want to turn into a musical? And what's a musical you'd want to turn into a movie?
Oh my gosh. Again, another one I was thinking about last night. So hard. Okay, I don't necessarily maybe have a movie, but they're Pink. I think her music would lend so well.
Yes.
Oh yeah.
To musical theater because I feel like her songs are always super story driven.
Yeah.
So I feel like, I'm like, girl, where are you? We need you.
Right. Kind of like the Once Upon a One More Time, where it's like a story, but they have like Britney songs just thrown in there.
Yes, exactly.
They do that with Pink songs for sure.
Yeah, no,
100%, right?
I had a Pink phase, and I was like, I was thinking about Pink the other day too, and that's actually so funny, because I was like, you know how you like go back in time, and like look at like old music? So I was like Nicki Minaj, and I was like at Pink, and yeah, Pink, definitely. I agree.
It would slay.
Yes.
It would slay.
And she's so underrated, and it's like, give her her shine, guys.
Please. Okay, the woman is doing like somersaults in the air.
Literally.
Giving Cirque du Soleil. Yes. Like, incredible.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, a musical into a movie. I'm still waiting for Spring Awakening. I'm still waiting.
Right?
Yeah. Agreed.
And I mean, they're getting all this attention because of 15 years. Why not make it a movie now?
Right.
Exactly. Let's go.
And I feel like it would be a really good movie too. So I would literally like go to the movie box and see that. So
Yeah. So yeah, that's what I would say.
What was it like doing Wicked?
Amazing. I was so privileged to be in that show, especially because I didn't think I'd ever get the opportunity to do it. Mm. I had never really seen Black women doing the show.
Yeah.
And so when they were like, yes, you got the job, I was like, am I dreaming right now? Like, this is incredible. We grew up with the show and I loved the score. It was just like one of those mega musicals when I was growing up. And so having the opportunity to do it and like see the bubble come down like so close. I mean, it was magical. It's a magical show.
It really is.
And also as an ensemble member, being one of the kids in the classroom, and you just feel so a part of the story of watching these two women, fight and then excel like into their own world. So I just felt really privileged to be a part of that history, And the costumes are fire.
Oh, yeah. They're gorgeous. Yeah. Oh my goodness.
And you understudied Madame Morrible.
I did.
You were kind of young. So what was that like?
Yeah, it's like super cool.
Yeah, like usually Madame Morrible was like 50.
Yeah.
Again, another shock. I was like, are y'all sure about this? Like, I'm going to do my best, but whatever. It was my first time understudying in a Broadway show, and I was so nervous, and the team was so kind to me, and we just, like, worked on it. I didn't get to go on ever, but that's fine.
Right.
I think, like, if my time there had been a bit longer, mm-hmm. I think eventually I would have gotten my shot, but being able to, me and Celia Hotstein got to do our put in together, and so just being able to watch her do her Glinda, and then for me, I was just like, this is wild, like, where childhood dreams are coming true, like, right now,
mm-hmm.
right now. So yeah, I mean, in those costumes, I just like, I can't. The Madame Morrible costume, I was like, this is fire,
yes,
and that wig.
The wig!
So good.
I never thought I could be a blonde, but I'm like, it grew on me. It grew on me.
What was it like doing Aladdin?
Again, amazing, amazing, amazing. I did it 3.5-4 years, the longest show I've ever been in. And it kind of felt like grad school to me because I was with so many veterans in the business who had done like 5, 6, 7 Broadway shows. And I learned so much from them about Broadway and about being able to sustain yourself and growing as an individual amongst this large entity. And I have lifelong friends. Like, the people in that show are my family. I would do anything for them. And it was just a beautiful time of my life. I grew up so much doing that show, and I'm forever grateful for Disney for giving me my Broadway debut.
Yes. What was it like? What was the company audition process like?
Oh my gosh. It was fast and furious.
Really?
It was like me and one other person. We were kind of the last two to be cast in the process. Mm-hmm. And so I got a call in December, like, hey, do you want to come in? And I was like, sure. And it was 3 auditions, and usually that's how it works for me. Like, Aladdin was the same way. I had 3 auditions and then I got it, and I was like, whoa, Wicked, 3 auditions, boom, boom. And this was the initial call, and our associate director and our associate music director were there with the camera and the casting director, and they put everything on tape. And then I was called back for a movement call with our U.S. associate choreographer. I did the movement call, and I was like, that was super fun. Like, I don't think it'll go any further. Mm. I was super young, and I knew the people that they had cast to play a majority of the husbands. And I was like, I would love to do this show, but I don't know if the pairings would link up if I were to ever go on, and then we got to the final callback, and I was like, oh my God, this is it. We're getting serious now.
Right.
We like worked on the material a lot in the audition. I think, the Sarah scene is what we worked on the most, and then I did the Bless This Day singing.
That whole thing.
Yeah. Yeah, and we put it all on tape, and then I found out the day after Christmas that I got the show.
It's crazy.
And then you became one of those good and crazy people, her friends.
That's right. That's right. Yeah.
What is it like doing company, and what has been your favorite moment or memory?
Oh, man. It's been... I feel like I keep saying this. I'm like, it's been amazing, but it really has.
It's okay. It's perfect.
It's been incredible. Company was a show that was the last show that I did in college. I did it at Cornell. I didn't go to Cornell University, but like sometimes we'd like switch off and do shows there. And I played Marta in that production, and I was like, you know what? That's it. I probably will never do a Sondheim again. Like, I'm cherishing this moment.
This is it.
This is it. Because, you know, like, again, like, one of the few people that I saw doing Sondheims was Audra. Like, there wasn't very many Black people, Black women doing it on, like, a major platform, like Broadway. And so I was like, that's it. Whatever. And so... having the opportunity to be in the show and to be a part of the recreation process of this iconic show and watch, I mean, you know, one of my favorite memory is watching Stephen Sondheim watch our first run through, like one of our final run throughs in the space before the pandemic. And he was just laughing and singing along, and he was just so excited and just so moved at the end. He talked to us and he was just moved to tears about how he felt that we really honored George Firth's words and his work. And I'll never forget it. I was like, this is amazing. Like, I can't believe that I have a job where I get to observe people that I have admired for so long work their genius with this piece. And then just like, so it's been incredible, and the fact that this incredible company has also welcomed the understudies when we've had to go on for, because usually understudy is like we go on for one or two performances, but having, you know, with COVID, sometimes we're on for 10 days straight, that's really unheard of. So having them be so welcoming and asking what we need and how, you know, creating our relationship so that when we go on stage together that it's, you know, believable and
organic.
It's organic. Yes. It's been such a thrill. And touring with, I mean, every single person is a heavy hitter. Like, people I've been, like, listening to on recordings. Like, I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Every day I'm like, I can't believe this is my job. Like, how did I get here?
Right. And, like, how about that moment when Bobby was Black? Jenny was Black, Sarah was Black, and I think Susan was Black. Like, all of them were Black. That was
crazy.
Wild.
I would pay to see that. I would pay to see that.
It was wild. I mean, I'm so glad we got a photo of it, because I was like, this will probably never happen again. Just in terms of this run, like, I think, like, once the show goes out and does whatever it, you know, needs to do after Broadway, you know, a long time from now, like, you know, it's going to take off into its own entity, but it was such a special moment. And, especially, you know, with Nikki and Brittany, I think what sometimes people forget about being an understudy, especially with a new show, is that we've been waiting like 2-3 years to perform these roles, you know, and to be able to hear Nikki and Brittany sing being alive for the first time and, well, not for the first time, but, you know, the first time in front of an audience and also be on stage, like, it took me everything not to just be like, just cry. Truly.
Right.
Truly, you know, because it's so special and it was so fun. He had so much fun up there.
I'm sure.
Yeah.
But now we have some of our special company questions.
Okay.
So the first one relates to being alive, and that is, what is something that you need to be alive?
Music. 100%. Like, it's everything. It's the first thing I think about when I wake up. It's the last thing I think about when I go to bed. It's such a motivator in my life. It's like my language. So that's definitely what I need for sure.
Ladies who lunch, who are five people would you love to have lunch with, dead or alive?
Okay, so when I think about this question, I think about like having a like lunch party. So I'm like, who do I want all at this table to facilitate some great conversation? You know, okay, so this is what I've come up with today. It could change, but so we got Tracee Ellis Ross.
Okay.
We have Pearl Bailey, because she is one of my favorite icons of the theater and of television. I just think she's so incredible. Maxine Waters. Tracee, Pearl, Maxine, Audrey Hepburn.
Okay.
My God, what was the last one? Queen Latifah.
Oh, yes.
What a stunning list.
Yeah, that's a really good list. You really thought about this one, because I don't know what I would say. We were asked this earlier, and
yeah,
we were like,
yeah,
oh, the Pumas,
we were put on the spot, and I was like,
the Oprah, like, with the ones that you know.
I'm like, I was talking to my cousin last night, and like, we kind of went around and like, you know, I was like, what do you think? Like, what would you do? And I was like, because you've watched those like actor on actors like variety episodes.
Yeah. Yes.
Like, I would want it to be like that, and we have like a nice sit down. Yeah. I think it would be good.
That's a good list.
Mm-hmm. Another 100 people. What is the craziest thing you've seen on the train or a subway station?
Ooh. What's the craziest thing? I'm trying to think of the craziest PG thing that I've ever seen.
It could be a little PG-13.
Yeah.
If you can make it like that.
Excuse me. Well, I would say probably, oh gosh, I've been on the train for so long, I'm like,
Yeah.
I mean, I do see the same woman singing every single day on my train. Every single day.
Is she, like,
day.
Performing, or is she just sitting down singing?
She's performing a little bit.
Okay.
She's performing a little bit, so I'm like, ooh, like, I know it's gonna be a day when I see her come on. I've seen, like, a full drum circle.
Oh.
Obviously, we got Showtime, which is iconic. I've seen people smoking on the train, like,
love
the,
that.
In the window, and just fully. And I'm like, I
kids,
you know,
don't
I
do that at home.
Cars now, don't do that at home.
No.
So yeah, I've seen a wide variety of things.
We've asked people this question, and it's hard to like answer because you are on the train like every day.
Yeah.
So like to pinpoint like one moment was like, that's crazy.
That was crazy.
Hard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Luckily, I haven't, like, I'm so scared. I mean, we've all seen those videos of, like, rats coming on the train.
Yes,
and, like,
that's what Nikki said. She was talking about the rats.
Mm-mm. Or, like, there was that one video a couple of years ago. Someone had insects and just, like, released them. And I was like, oh, no.
I would have passed out. I am, like, super scared of, like, bugs, spiders, anything. So
yeah.
I would have been, like, fainting right there and then. Someone had to drag me to get me off the train.
Yep. I was like, nope, that's it for me. Thank you so much. Bye.
No, but like one day I want to see the rat man. Like the man dressed up as a rat.
Oh, yeah. He's going to be like jumping around.
Yes.
Yeah.
And like classical
I believe
scenes.
He was actually in Sleep No More. Like he was a part of that, like the start of that. Yeah. Like in the cast.
Wow.
So. You know, he's not afraid of the avant-garde.
No. Company. Who is a castmate from any Broadway show that you've been in that would be the best company at any time?
You're going to get me in trouble right now. This question. Man, I have several people. I'm going to say, like, there's a core group of folks that are like, yes. One of them is Jacob, who's in company with me right now.
Jacob Dickey?
Jacob Dickey. We both did Aladdin together. I would say my Zenden girls. Like, so in my our dressing room at the Jacobs is called the Zenden. Mm. So Brittany and Anisha and I, we all share a dressing room together. So, like, it would always be fun wherever we go.
So, so are you in Tower 1 or Tower 2?
You're in Tower 2.
Oh, okay.
Yes, yeah. So that Tower 2 has the most dressing
rooms. Yeah.
Yes. So we all share one. So then, and then, I would say Trent, my bestie Trent from Aladdin, Nathan, who was also in Aladdin. Good crew. Olivia Donaldson, who is in Six right now.
Yes.
We went to college together and she replaced me at Aladdin. Yeah. Yeah.
But now we can play a game. So we have three games. The first one is put a finger down. So we'll give you 10 prompts and you'll put a finger down.
Second game is guess the musical. It's a song lyric or a song title from the show. And if you don't get it the first time, there is clues.
And the third one is guess the playbill. This one is quite easy, but we'll show you a blurred picture of a playbill and you'll have to guess it.
Yeah.
So you can do the first one, second one, third one, two of them, all of them, whatever you want.
Oh my God, they all sound very fun. I guess maybe the first two?
Yeah.
Let's see if we have time for the third.
Right.
I don't know. Yeah, okay.
Okay. 10 fingers.
Okay.
Put a finger down if you've rejected plans because of rehearsal.
Mm-hmm.
Put a finger down if you cried at closing night.
Haven't.
Oh, second person today.
Second person, yes.
I haven't, oh no.
Put a finger down if you've been noticed on the street.
I have, yes.
Put a finger down if a famous person came to your show.
Yep.
Put a finger down if you've burped or farted on stage.
Yeah.
Put a finger down if you've fallen on stage.
Oh, well, we all know that.
Put a finger down if your voice cracked on stage.
Yep.
Put a finger down if you got gifts from fans.
I have, yeah.
Put a finger down if you played multiple roles in a show.
Yes.
Okay, done. You got most of the fingers down.
Yeah.
Ew.
You're a second person today that says that they have not cried at closing night, and most people cry all the time at closing night. So
yeah,
you're that 1%.
1%. It's not because I'm not. I think I'm overwhelmed in the moment.
Yeah.
And so when I go home, that's when I boom. You know what I mean? All the emotions come out. But I'm just like, oh my God, so much is happening right now.
Yeah, I definitely get that. Like, I'm one of those people that, cannot figure out my emotions, in the moment. And then, days later, I'd be like, oh, that's really sad. It's, so horrible because people are like, Savannah, react. And,
I know. So much is happening.
Yeah. What's a gift that you got from a fan that was, very, special or very, sweet?
Yeah, a friend of mine, her name is Jackie. She creates these little earrings that are playbills.
Oh.
And so she gave me company ones. They're really cute.
So cool.
And then when I was in Aladdin, we had a lot of Japanese fans, and this wonderful, wonderful, wonderful human made this, she sent it to the theater. It was a picture of all of us, but she had created little, cartoons of us.
Oh, that's so
cute. In our characters. It was so cute. Absolutely. And they displayed it on our call board because it was so beautiful what she did. Those are the two ones that come to mind.
That's cute.
Yeah. Do you have a funny burp or farted on stage story about you or someone else farting and you having to endure that?
And walk into it and witness, smell that.
Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh, am I going to say this? Oh my God, I have unfortunately farted in the middle of Ladies Who Lunch.
No.
And
it made me laugh. Huh?
In the club, in the club scene.
In the club. Yeah, and it made me laugh, and it was, like, super hard to keep it together for the rest. Because, you know, it's a very serious moment.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, my God, I can't believe I just did this.
Did anyone, like, give you, like, side eyes? Like, I know this girl did not just...
I think I was able... It happened far enough away.
Okay, good.
But, like, you know, you still have that panic that, like, people are gonna walk through. Yeah. Oh, my God. Just...
Oh.
Why?
Wow. Yes. When I saw Company, I was thinking, like, what if someone farted in that box during the opening number? And you had to smell that while doing all the dance moves.
My God. That would be horrifying. Yeah.
Yes. Literally. Literally.
Oh, man.
But now we can do Guess the Musical.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So your first clue is Loathing.
Wicked.
Yes. The end is coming.
The end is coming. I don't know. Beetlejuice comes to mind, but I don't know.
I can give you a clue. Simple okay. Sponge.
Oh. SpongeBob?
Yes. Yeah, yeah.
Yay! I loved that show.
Yes, so good.
So did we.
So good.
So did we.
Yes. Yeah.
Stupid with Love.
Thoroughly Modern Millie?
Close, close. No, do you want the clue?
Very close.
Yeah.
On Wednesdays, we wear pink.
Oh. Mean Girls.
Yes.
Yes.
Somewhere in the middle of nowhere.
Somewhere in the middle of nowhere?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Gosh, you're going to have to give me a clue.
I have a good one for this one. Okay. It's your next door neighbor, the theater.
Come From Away?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I see. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Gary, Indiana.
Music Man.
Yes. Cape Cow Hair Slipper.
Into the Woods.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Chip on My Shoulder.
Legally Blonde. My favorite.
Yes.
My fave.
Let It Go.
Frozen.
Yes.
Another 100 People.
Company.
Turn It Off.
Book of Mormon.
Yes. Arabian Nights.
Aladdin.
Yes. You got all of them.
You did really good.
You did really good.
Yes.
No, like really good. Like I think probably one of our like top threes that have done it. Yeah.
Yes.
Work. I love that. And like, I stand.
Not even on purpose. All of your shows were in there.
Yeah.
That wasn't even on purpose. Like that was, I didn't even realize it was going to be
No, I didn't
like
realize
that.
Either. I was like, wait.
That's so funny.
Yes. But what time is it? Do you want to just do Guess That Playbill?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
It's time for Guess That Playbill.
Company.
Yes. You got it.
That was
easy.
Wicked.
Yeah. Just act like it's a little hard.
Yeah, just gonna be like,
oh, crap.
Oh, man. Santa.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
You got it.
Oh, falsetto.
Yes.
I thought this one was gonna be the hard one.
No, everyone's getting it. It's so easy. Because you just say the name.
Yeah. Oh, well, Annie.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Welcome to the land where we come from away.
Yes, you got it. Last one.
Come on.
Lion King.
Yes, you did all of them.
But now we're going to do quick round.
Okay.
So these are rapid fire questions.
They're fast.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, the crap. They're all like, we have like notes over here, like all backwards.
So yes. I was like, okay. Favorite Halloween costume?
Oh my God, what's her name? Scooby-Doo in the glasses.
Velma?
Thank you.
Oh, yeah, okay, Velma. Okay. Yes. Harry Potter house.
Gryffindor.
Favorite holiday?
Christmas.
Favorite song?
What's love got to do with it? Got to do with it.
Yes.
Favorite actor?
Jude Law?
Oh, okay, yeah. Okay. I agree. Yeah. Favorite musical?
That's so hard. it's a tie between Legally Blonde and Spring Awakening at the moment.
Yes. Favorite food?
Anything cooked by my abuela. She's Cuban and so good.
Favorite color?
Green.
Favorite beverage?
Used to be Diet Coke. I'm trying to stick to water.
I like that.
You were a Diet Coker?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Really? Oh, yeah.
I feel like a lot of Diet Cokes always do switch with water eventually. Like, I feel like they're, like, super close. They're, like, super close, so.
Yeah.
favorite place to eat in New York?
Ooh, Victor's Cafe, Cuban restaurant. My family has been going there since they moved to this country, so it's, like, a staple.
That sounds good. That sounds really good.
It's really good.
Yeah, I'm a foodie, so I always try to, like, find new places to eat and, like, try different things, so, yeah.
Biggest pet peeve?
Oh, okay, if I'm going to a show and someone is singing along
to
the show.
Same. Some people do.
No, do I only that. Did it. Oh, listen, I was nine. I was nine, and I saw SpongeBob.
And that's acceptable.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
But, like, there's also a layer to this. I knew the music before. I like to be surprised, right? But
me too.
I knew the whole play before I even saw it because this guy spoiled the whole thing.
No.
So I knew everything from word to word. And he's like, had the audacity to sing over the music. I was just like...
Well, I mean, that was okay, but, like, if somebody goes to the Jacobs Theater and starts belting out
Being
Alive with Katrina Lang, which I hope has not happened.
It isn't.
Okay.
It's like saying something like you really wanted to see.
I came here to see.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. What'd you say?
I was saying I came here to see the girls do what they gotta do.
Yeah, right.
You know?
Yeah.
I didn't pay to hear you next to me or behind me.
Yeah. Oh my god.
But you know.
It's like if I saw Beetlejuice, I would be so mad if someone was like next to me singing Beetlejuice.
I
would
be like, what happened there?
I would be like, oh guys, please, please.
Yeah.
Favorite sitcom?
Golden Girls?
I like that, yes. It's a good one.
Favorite Broadway costume?
That I've worn or that I've seen?
You've worn.
Aladdin Greg Barnes made this incredible dress for the attendants. And he like remade mine when I came into the show, which I'm like, I can't believe he did that. And it was lined with Swarovski crystal. It was honestly the most beautiful thing I've ever worn.
Wow.
Do you have a picture of that?
I think I have a picture of it in the fitting. Cause Lynn Bacchus, she's like a very famous, dress maker.
Yeah.
Costume maker in the industry, and so she's in the photo, like fitting it. I think I might have.
Maybe we can like put it up there. Favorite fruit?
Mangoes.
Yes. Same.
Lastly, favorite ice cream flavor?
Mint chocolate chip.
Ooh, yes. Same. I love mint chocolate chip.
It's so good.
Uh huh. Yeah, that's it.
That's it.
Yes.
This is so lovely.
Oh, I have a thing. You know, like, did you, when you went to Radio City, did the ice cream shop next, have you ever tried their mint chocolate chip ice cream? It's like right next.
What is it called? Like Van Leeuwen or something?
Van Lauren. Yeah, I don't know.
Van Leeuwen.
Yes.
Yes. I've been to Van Leeuwen. Like, they have a couple all over.
Yes.
But yes, I do love their mint chocolate chip. It's really good.
So good. Mm-hmm. So good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Hey guys! Thanks for watching.
Remember to like, subscribe, turn on post notifications so you can have every update. We hope you've been enjoying our company videos.
Make sure to go to our website, BroadwayTimeOnline.com, to view our most recent news coverage, including the Tony Awards, American Pops Orchestra Concert, and this Sunday, the Juneteenth event. Tune in next week for our interview with
Manu Narayan! Woo!